Let me just give a overall quick guidance on the question of if I'm starting from scratch, how do I build an online community? Like, what's my current recommendation for that? And so I'll just make it a simple answer, and then we can continue the conversation. Instagram carousel posts boosted with ads to potentially ideal audiences, and then net carrying to do collaborations with other influencers. Okay, so I'm just gonna keep it simple and just do those two things real quick. So let me explain that mouthful. Okay, so the first step is to write your messages that you want to inspire your future true fans. And that's really the mindset to have. It's not trying to please your current friends and colleagues. This is important. Unless some of your current friends and colleagues you can also imagine as your future true fans because they're just really supportive of your energy, they're supportive of your message. That's not always true for the people we start with in the beginning of our audience building. So your future true fans are the people who, once they find you, they can't help but resonate with both your message and your energy, your presence. It's just your personality, the way that you come across, everything from your voice to how you look to the way you carry yourself and the way you write, everything part of your energy signature, even the stars, you know, your astrological compatibility, whatever. It's all part of it. Your future true fans resonate with all that, which means you can be yourself. You don't have to try to get someone's attention because your future true fans, it's kind of like you're calling their name in a crowded marketplace. And it's kind of like if you've ever been in a crowd, and like there's lots of talk in the crowd, but then you hear George, you hear Rishab. I'm talking to Rishab right now. Like it could be a whisper and you hear it because it's your name, you know? And so that's the same thing with your true fans. You can just whisper. And even in the loud crowded marketplace, they'll hear their name because they sense your energy. Anyway, so write your uplifting, inspiring, educational, not too detailed. You know, you can read my article about what's the difference between free content and premium or paid content. There's a difference. Do the free content, okay? Do that using Instagram carousel posts. And I'll just quickly share my screen just for those who don't know what I'm talking about. I do this on a regular basis on Instagram, and I recommend it highly because it's worked really, really well for building an audience through messages, you know, through kind of thoughtful messages, especially a cold audience, especially a cold audience, okay? Not video for cold audience, carousel post for cold audience. The problem with video for cold audiences is when you run ads, Facebook and Instagram says, hey, they watched 3 seconds. There must be part of your warm audience now. They're roped into the warm audience. Even though they may have hated you after the 3 seconds, I don't want to ever see this person again. 3 seconds, too bad. Instagram carousel, you know, says they're part of your warm. But with carousels, if they don't resonate with the first message, they're not going to click through to the second message. So you filter, it's good for filtering away people who are not part of your ideal audience. So carousels are like this. It's an article basically, but I split it up into a bunch of slides. You could see a bunch of them, you know, on my Instagram if you wanted, like, you know, and some of them can be quite dense. Look at this, it's quite dense, but people love it, as you can see. You know, people love it. Lots of people say, wow, this is great. People read it if they're part of your true audience, if they're part of your true fans, they'll read it. So Instagram carousel posts, and then learn to use Instagram ads to get it out to potential ideal fans. And we can talk more about that. I have a whole course on Facebook ads teaching you how to do detailed targeting and testing audiences to know which audience, anyway, that kind of stuff. It's not just about the quantity. It's not just about the engagement metrics. Like, oh, this audience got me a lower cost per engagement. No. You have to look at the profiles of the likers from your ads to see if you're actually reaching the right people. Because there's lots of audiences that have low cost per engagement. It's not the right people. If you look at their profiles, you're like, wait, I'm not reaching the right people. So important to test audiences. So Instagram carousel posts boosted to the right audiences will start to build a community, start to build engagement for you over several months. People have to see you several times again and again before they even click the first like. This is important. You can't just say, hey, George, I ran a $10 ad to the XYZ audience, didn't get a single like, so it must not be the right audience. What are you talking about? Do you expect that, you know, again, crowded marketplace. If I say Rishab quietly once and you didn't hear my name and you're like, yeah, that didn't work. I should start with, no, I said, Rishab. By the third time or fourth time, you're like, wait, even if I'm whispering, you're like, wait, someone's calling my name. And then if I whisper the fourth, fifth, sixth time, you're like, oh yeah, that's where the whisper is coming from. And you start to, you know, then you start to engage with me. Six times. I don't know what the number is. Now, George, science says 7 times, 13 times, 24 times. That science is just bunk on that stuff. It depends, obviously, on the person. So, but I know it's more than once that they need to see your post before they decide to even engage. Even if they liked it the first time, they might not engage. Second, third, fourth, fifth, 18th time, you know, eventually people start to engage. But testing an audience, usually 3 ads to a single audience, you'll start to get some likes to test, look at those profiles to see if you're reaching the right people. So Instagram carousel post ads, Instagram, the reason for Instagram and not Facebook and not Google and not YouTube and not Twitter ads or not LinkedIn ads is many reasons. But Instagram is where the holistic, spiritual wellness people are. People who are more interested in personal growth, more interested in spiritual growth, more interested than the average person on the planet, and also more means to pay for development, personal development. That's part of the filter. Instagram is like Facebook. Facebook is like the whole planet, right? Just about everybody has now 3 billion people, you know, check into Facebook once a month, right? It's most internet users check into Facebook once a month. Now you take the Facebook audience and you say, give me the 40 to 50% of the higher income, people more likely to be interested in wellness, outdoors, arts, beauty, personal growth, entrepreneurship. Give me that segment. Culture creatives, loosely speaking. Good. Instagram says, here we are, the 40 to 50% of the planet that's more like that. Good. Well, then why don't we just reach them there? Good. Yeah, easy. It's already a giant filter there for you. So that's why Instagram carousel ads. Okay, got it? Now, as you start building an audience, then you can move to the next level, which is to do collaborations with other people who have a bit of an audience. Now, after doing several months of Instagram ads with carousel posts, you now have maybe a couple hundred Instagram followers. And not just any, the people who actually are engaging with your message, right? We can talk about nurturing the warm audience with videos, which I do obviously all the time, and a separate video. But that's, we're just building from scratch. And then the next level is going to other influencers who have up to 300% the size of your audience to say, hey, can we interview each other? You could do that through Instagram. You could do that through Instagram Live. You know, that's a nice way of doing it because it does a lot of notifications to both audiences that you're live. But if you just want to record it on Zoom, that's okay too. And then you can upload to Instagram with, you know, with captions automatically generated. So simplest. So then you interview each other. So when I say up to 300% audience, let's say after a few months, you've got 100 Instagram followers that are real. Like they actually are engaging, many of them are engaging, 100 Instagram followers. You can then reach out to somebody with up to 300, let's say. I mean, in the early stages, even 500 is okay. 300 to 500 Instagram followers, they might be willing to interview, cross interview with you. And the interview doesn't have to be long. It could just be like, hey, let's just get to know each other, but also, you know, kind of learn about each other's work publicly, okay, by asking each other's questions about each other's work and then some kind of tip that is useful for my, I'll ask you questions about some tip that's useful for my audience and you could do the same and you could introduce each other's work a little bit. So, yeah. So anyway, I'll stop there and then we can continue the conversation from here. A couple of quick follow-up questions for those who are live with me here is that Angie says, am I kind of going away from Facebook ads? No, I'm not. I still run Facebook ads a lot. It's just that for people who are, you know, just, you know, wanting to focus on a simpler method, I would just say Instagram ads is where I would recommend starting. It's also more encouraging. Instagram is more encouraging of a platform than Facebook. You get more likes and engagement than Facebook. But Facebook is great too. Obviously, there's many more people there. It's just, again, the Instagram is a filter for the culture creatives, which is most of whom we want to reach. And then once you learn Instagram ads, do it well, then I would say Facebook ads gives you a much bigger audience, literally double the size of the audience. But not all the doubling is people you want to reach. So you have to keep testing on the Facebook ads. So, and then the another question is, let's see here. And the question, Sanaz, great question. Are people who are 40 and older on Instagram? Yes, absolutely. No question. Of course, the Instagram audience trends a little younger, but there are still millions and millions of tens of millions, hundreds of millions, actually. Well, I would say tens of millions of 40 plus on Instagram. And like I said, they tend to be higher income than the people who just, if you randomly picked a Facebook user versus an Instagram user. So absolutely, I have lots of good experiences reaching, my actually ideal demographic is also 40 plus. I have some 30 plus folks, and some of you are even younger than that. Congratulations on getting started early. I wish I had started at your age, but I wasn't wise enough until I was like, you know, just last week. So in my 40s, to do this kind of, you know, authentic business.